Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.5 Beta 1. This is currently available to developers and hopefully soon to public beta testers. This came in at 5.53 gigabytes, that's on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it was similarly sized on all the devices you'll see here. Anytime you go from a public version to a beta, it's going to reinstall the whole OS, and the same thing happens when you go from a beta to a public version. So there are about 5 gigabytes on all the devices, the iPhone 8 Plus, iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021, as well as the iPhone 11. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About, and you can see the build number is 19F5047E. And this is our first beta in quite some time, and there are some changes in it, so we'll go over that in just a moment. However, Apple also announced WWDC today. That's where they show off the next version of iOS and macOS and iPadOS and so on. And so as you can see here, it's WWDC 22. It'll be a remote event for most people. If you're a developer or a student, you can apply to watch it in person. However, it will be a pre-recorded online event for most people, and you'll see it's from June 6th to June 10th. You can watch it online, typically on apple.com or usually on YouTube. The odd thing is they haven't given a specific time for it yet. Usually it's at 10 a.m. Pacific time or 1 p.m. Eastern time. So it usually will be at that time. We don't have those specific times. Typically it would say, but it hasn't yet. You can also see this in the Apple Developer app. Now, as far as other updates, Apple did release a ton of other updates along with this, such as iPadOS 15.5 Beta 1, watchOS 8.6 Beta 1, tvOS 15.5 Beta 1, HomePodOS 15.5 Beta 1, and macOS 12.4 Beta 1. All of those are available to developers now. Now, the first new thing is a modem update. We have a modem update with the 13 Pro Max. We went from version 1.59.03 to 1.60.00 on the 13 Pro Max. This typically will help with connectivity and hopefully switching between LTE and 5G and so on, but we won't know until we use it for a few days. Now, the first new feature is when you go into messages, so we'll go into messages here. Within Messages, you'll see at the bottom it says Apple Cache. This is a rebranding from before. So if we take a look at 15.4.1 on the left, it says Apple Pay. Here it says Apple Cache. So they've rebranded Apple Pay to Apple Cache, and they've also made a similar change within the Wallet app. So if we go into the Apple Wallet app, now within the Wallet app, you can see here it says Apple Cache at the top, and we now have a Request and Send Money button. So we can request or send directly from the Wallet app, just making it a little bit easier to do that. Also, Apple is apparently planning to rebrand something else within the wallet, such as iTunes Pass. Apparently that's going to be called Apple Pass in the future, where you'll be able to use a QR code with it and pay at an Apple store. So that's something we've seen code for, we haven't actually seen physically yet. Another thing we found code for, and thanks to my friend Steve Mosier, is within the music app or within the iPhone itself, there's references to Apple's new classical music service called Apple Classical. So there's things where you could open up classical music. I couldn't find the actual reference to open it within a classical music app, but there is reference to that, so we should see that fairly soon. We've heard about this for a while since Apple bought a classical music streaming service. We should see that very soon on the iPhone. Now there's another change within the Watch app. So if we go into Watch, there's something new that we haven't really heard of before. So along with watchOS 8.6, if we go under Accessibility, within Accessibility, go under VoiceOver, and within VoiceOver, we go down to where we have hand gestures. Under hand gestures, if we tap on one of the gestures, you can see here we have a new option for Magic Tap. We're not really sure what this is specifically, so there is a new gesture called Magic Tap that they've added. You can set it for any one of these gestures and use Magic Tap. So I'll be testing that out a little bit further in the future with watchOS 8.6 once it's updated to that, but it's something new that's there. Also within the code is Sports Kits updates. What that means is if you're going to watch the new Friday Night Baseball, they'll be able to update the score in real time and have that pop up on your screen and things like that. So there's additions for that already within the code, ready to go as soon as baseball is live. So we should see that very soon. If we go into Books, if you use the Books app on your iPhone, within Books, within the bookstore, if we go to Browse Sections, there will be a new section for a store for manga. So this is something I wasn't able to find here, but there will be a manga store with a new icon as well. That was found in the code, as you can see here, and it looks like there's going to be a manga store. Now, if you're seeing this, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, but I wasn't able to see it with 15.5 15.5, but it does look like we're going to have that manga store within the book section. So that's something they've updated as well. Now, as far as any additional changes or updates, there isn't anything specific that I could find other than what I mentioned right there. Typically with the first beta, we'll have small changes, and then with beta 2, we get more and more, such as that Face ID unlock with a mask feature we had before. You usually don't see those within the first beta. We'll get the larger changes later on, and then of course, iOS 16 with WWDC should have all of the major changes. As far as resolved issues and known issues, Apple's only mentioned one thing as far as known issues. There are no resolved issues mentioned in their notes, so there's nothing about the music bug taking up additional battery drain, but it may have been fixed with 15.4.1. However, the one thing they did mention is if you're using an iPad and you use Universal Control with 15.5 is not compatible with the current version of macOS. You will need macOS 12.4 betas and iPadOS 15.5 in order for that feature to work. So if you're wondering if you should install iOS 15.5 beta 1 or iPadOS 15.5 beta 1, don't install it if you don't plan to upgrade everything. Now, as far as bugs and everything else, and you're wondering if you should install it, if you want to try out any of the new features or to look for different changes, you definitely could do that. But being an early beta, if you're getting used to maybe having great battery life with 15.4.1, I might hold off for a bit until Apple updates it again and we see what it's like after a few days with the follow-up video I typically do on the weekend. So as far as battery life with 15.4.1, it's been pretty good, but it will take a few days to know what it's like. And you can see my capacity's at 100%. And if we go over the last 10 days, battery has actually been pretty good on the current version, but it will take a few days for everything to stabilize and then see what a full day will get us through. So I would expect decent battery life, but again, we just don't know until we've used it for a while. Performance-wise, it does seem to perform quite well. I've had no issues here, and I did run benchmarks as well, but on the iPhone 11 or the iPhone 8 Plus that I have here, I did notice that it was quite smooth on the 8 Plus. It was very fast when I was scrolling after initially installing it, looking for new features and changes, and it seems to be performing as you would expect. Of course, you can see my widgets are incorrect right now, so those will probably update in a little while, but let's go ahead and take a look at the benchmarks. As far as the benchmarks go, we'll take a look at Geekbench 5, and you'll see it scored 1,733 for single core, 4,589 for multi-core on my 13 Pro Max. If we take a look at the history, it is slightly lower than we had before, so it didn't increase, but typically it will take a few hours or a few days for everything to sort of settle in the background and for this to kind of stabilize. So these can actually increase since I ran them right after installing the update. Now let's take a look at all of the devices here. And you can see from the left, we have the iPad Pro from 2021, followed by the iPhone 8 Plus, then the iPhone 11, and then the 13 Pro Max. And again, this is just to give you an idea if your numbers are anywhere near this or similar. They basically will be similar if you're using this update and everything's settled down. They could even be much better. But as long as they're within 100 or so, everything is usually fine. Now, as far as iOS 15.5 Beta 2, typically since we're on Beta 1, it's usually a 2-week wait. So at this point, we can expect it within a couple weeks. Of course, Apple has been odd lately with pushing out different updates and betas, so this is always subject to change, but we could see it as soon as next week, but typically every couple of weeks with a final release, usually around WWDC in June. So that's when we'll see iOS 16 and all of the new versions for the first time, and then we'll have iOS 15 betas all the way up until September, where they typically release iOS 16 or the next version along with the next version of phones such as iPhone 14. So that's normally what Apple does. So we can expect a new beta within a couple weeks. So again, I'll let you know what this is like to use. Usually around Saturday or Sunday after I've used it for a few days, and I'll have a poll about this to see what it's been like for you as well. Now, if you've already installed this update and you found any additional features, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.